6 now. It's been a controversial past few days for TV host Nick Cannon. As we reported this week, he's been dragged online, condemned publicly, and even fired, all for voicing hateful and anti-Semitic conspiracy theories. He later apologized, but despite the public "I'm sorry," many still question why history's oldest hatred is still prevalent today. Joining me now, the founder of the American Truth Project and Daily Ledger contributor, Barry Nussbaum. Barry, so do schools need to rethink how they teach about the Holocaust, for example?
Oh, there's no question about it. The Holocaust is the single most documented mass murder in world history. 6 million people were singled out for the reason that they were Jewish, no other reason, and slaughtered en masse in a way that has never been seen before. What I find so startling is not the ignorance of someone like the recent celebrity who just got caught, Nick Cannon, but there's a whole group of them, Puff Daddy or whatever he's called now, Ice Cube, Snoop Dogg, they're all besties with Louis Farrakhan, America's most infamous hater of white people, American people, and mostly Jewish people. So the question has to be raised, why are they getting away with parroting Farrakhan's words? And it's simple. Farrakhan has had his picture taken with President Clinton, with Jesse Jackson, with current members of Congress. He's borderline mainstream with his virulent hatred of Jews, and it becomes tolerable for a celebrity like Nick Cannon to parrot it. Look, it's history. It's not undocumented. It's ridiculously overdocumented, and to deny it is anti-Semitic.
And this leads me to something else that I've noticed. We've seen a lot of protests regarding racial inequity in the country, and it's certainly hit a boiling point in the last couple weeks or months. So this sort of ties in. A lot of these issues are intertwined as a society. Could changing the way that kids are taught about Black history in our country, could this perhaps solve this problem that we're seeing emerge, the problem of racism?
It is the perfect question to ask today. The reason being, the civil rights movement, specifically Black rights movement, was co-founded by Jews. And in the 60s, all those pictures you see with Martin Luther King, if there were white men walking with him on his marches, most of them were Jews. They were killed along with Blacks for the audacity of demanding rights for Blacks. Somehow, the peaceful protests of Martin Luther King have been replaced by mass violence, hatred, and literally intolerance for anybody that is outside the Black Lives Movement, a Matters movement, which is racist, which is at its core anti-Semitic, anti-American, anti-capitalist. I think if people go back to rights for all people and an equality and a level playing field, things will calm down, and it's education, real education, not a Farrakhan education, that needs to be in the schools. So I applaud Holocaust education. It ought to be a requirement, and it ought to be paired with Black history education so persecuted peoples understand we have the right to be equal to everyone else without prejudice.
And Barry, let me ask you this. Do you think the education system in our country is doing enough to teach kids about these issues, especially, and not just looking back at our history, but looking at what's happening right now? And if not, why are they avoiding doing so?
I'm really sad to say the answer to your perfect question is no. There are people on the street that get interviewed all the time by these roving reporters who don't even know what George Washington did, what Abraham Lincoln did, who Frederick Douglass was, and so on. There is not enough real history like it used to be taught when I was a kid, where you knew all the presidents and you knew what they stood for and you understood the Constitution and the Bill of Rights. Look, the average person on the street that's 25 can name the entire Kardashian family, but not the Vice President of the United States. And for $1 million, couldn't name a Supreme Court justice. Yeah. They don't understand civics, they don't know history, and they should.
And I think a lot of people probably agree with you, especially everything that's happening in our country right now. Barry, thank you.